is their upload speed?
1.5 meg.
Okay. So.
What is the, say, 25? Yeah?
We don't have the 100 by 25?
100 by 25 or?
We don't have that.
100 by 10?
No, the 100 was a pair of 1.5 meg.
Oh.
Okay, that's helpful.
So.
I was wondering, Sharon.
I liked the 10-year. I really think that to make measurable progress, we need the 10 years. But that said, I hear what people are saying, and I think the 25.3 is important enough that I could live with the 2020. I think it's still gonna be difficult to make a lot of measurable progress. We're talking about a handful of construction seasons. I mean, that's it. So, I mean, I think even if we went to 2022, that would be just, I just don't want us to have gone through this effort and, you know, really shake the tree at the legislature for more money and then be back with another speed goal and not have been able to show any progress. I hate symmetrical goals because for most people, they're completely useless and that is a fiber to the prem technology. But I don't mind having it mushy at 100, but 100 by 10 probably is perhaps something we could live with. But if we make it a stretch goal, I hear what, you know, you're saying, Denise, about somehow saying that 20% don't deserve 100 meg. I don't think that's what we're saying. I don't think that's what the last stretch goal was saying, but I could live with us getting rid of the percentage. We're not gonna get there. I mean, as long as everybody at the table understands it, the chances we're gonna get to 100 meg statewide, border to border, by 2026 is pretty de minimis. But that's what a stretch goal's for. I mean, it gives us something to work towards. That,
so, I put in 2020. Can people live with 2022 based on this construction season issue? It would give 3 cycles of legislature. It would give a new governor likely at least 1 3 to 4 year period to work on this too. So we could go 2020 or 2022. So I'm gonna just let that sit for a second. And I think that for the purposes of discussion, let's say at least 100 megabits download and 10 megabits upload. Okay, hold on. We're gonna go to Dick and then we'll come back.
I was just gonna say that for the second sentence of that thing is that we would just say that going forward after 2020 or 2022, that we would adhere to the federal
standard. We'll come back to that.
I'd just like a little bit of time to
process the 10.
Process the 10. And the reason is, I was in the room when the last speed goal was thrown against the wall, and everyone goes, yeah, 10 and 5, that sounds good. Well, 5 wasn't a sweet spot for my industry. Most of the providers in the traditional telephone company world are skipping 5. And, you know, so I'd like to get a better sense from my folks on what, you know, I want to make sure I don't pick a number that we don't do. That's
yeah,
my concern.
Yeah, I mean, that's, I think that's a fair concern, but can we get that?
I'm asking
okay.
Right now. So.
So let me just say, I don't know who else is in the room, but I'll just say this. When you reference the federal government in something at the state legislature, it usually upsets them. It agitates someone. So that's why I think the sort of we set a goal number in this instead of reference the feds in this, because who knows what happens to the FCC.
Well, so I that's a cool point. Thank you. That's cool. I'm wondering if we might a backwards way to get at that to say that Minnesota will not lag behind FCC standards, that as a state it is our goal to not be less than.
I'm willing to do that in the narrative of the report. I am unwilling to do it in the goal because of this issue. I just think you really, I'm trying to do it gently here, but it really, anytime you start to reference federal law and a state goal, it raises a set of concerns from the left and the right that become, if you want to know why we're having the driver's license issue, bingo. Bingo. So.
Margaret, if I may add to that, part of the reason is, and this is an overstatement, but I'm going to say it anyhow, because traditionally Minnesota does not receive, and I'll use a word that we use at the state all the time, their fair share of federal funding. That, you know, we just have this perception that we just don't get a fair deal. So why should we, so the, to Margaret's point, you know, there are some people who are going to look at this and say, why should we shoot for their goals when they really don't treat us fairly in return, you know? And it's not necessarily all based in all fact in every single area, but those become the sound bites and they get repeated and then people believe them. So I think if you don't, you know, I think of not mentioning it in a place that people are going to look at it, I think does not hurt.
I'm totally okay with adding something in the body and narrative of the report around what Bernadine is saying. That we don't lag behind, that we don't get behind, that we, but I think the actual goal, we need to be clear this is ownership over the goal for the state. Others. So this is what I have right now. I have is a state goal that no later than, I currently have 2020, I'm looking for a signal I can go to 2022 here. I'm looking for a bid, okay?
And Madam Chair, the last task force, I think it was like a 7-year period. It was 2009.
And then it got shortened by
2015.
So it didn't get passed until 2015.
I think it was 2009 when it was passed. Was it
2010?
10.
Was it 10?
It didn't make it till 10.
So that was about six full years.
So that would have been 3 cycles.
Yeah.
So going on to 2022 makes sense logistically, also especially given how short the session.
I'm just looking
at the person who had a shorter to 4 to try to get it back. If we can go to the 2 extra years.
I'm fine with that.
Okay. So then no later than 2022, all Minnesota businesses, homes, and institutions have access to high-speed broadband that provides minimum download speeds of at least 25 megabits per second, minimum upload speeds of 3 megabits per second. Also, by 2026, all Minnesota homes, businesses, and institutions will have access to at least one provider of broadband speeds. With right now on the table, we have a download of 10 megabits and upload of 110. And we're just looking for some confirmation here that we're not on the upload speed way off on an industry standard, which makes everybody's life a little crazier. We are. Okay, reaction.
Second, where it says all, you know, college and universities have access to high-speed broadband, provides a minimum of 25.
We dropped that.
Just, I'm thinking about striking high-speed, we just have access to broadband that provides minimum download speeds.
I don't know, someone would have to give me, that'd have to be, I think we've always been using high-speed as an indicator of an important marker for folks.
Just in my world, my perspective, that's not high speed. You know, so that's just where I
see. So you're saying that to label this 25.3 is not high speed in a world where we got 5 gigs coming up.
I mean, so that's just where my framing is.
Sure.
I don't, you know,
sure.
I'm one.
I understand now what you're saying.
Shannon.
The FCC defines high speed broadband as 25. I mean, that is what they call it. And that was in the 2015 broadband report, and I think it would be weird just to high speed out of it. I totally understand that in your world it's not, but for the majority of rural Minnesota, man, that would be pretty sweet.
Okay. So,
Maybe an approach would be to, in the body of the report, we can, where we talk about context and stuff, that point can you make, Neil, I'm just saying in another way, that this is our goal, but in the big world, 25 is really not, in a gig world, 25 is not really.
Respectfully, I think the report really captures that now. And then I think we're gonna discuss that, but I think in some ways it captures it too much. But, and that's a discussion for this afternoon, but I think the report really does get there.
So what I'm gonna do at this point is I would like to set this aside in the condition it's in and come back to it. We're leaving a lot of stuff here for the afternoon to see if we can nail down our upload speed on this. It may stay at 110. It may be somewhere in between based on information.
Are we leaving either, leaving it at a little bit more shade at 100 or going to 100 by 10?
Yes, but I think what we're leaning towards is getting the number that's in the second position correct. So that's what we're looking for. We're looking for some information and we don't have it. And I want to move on because I want to get to Burgundy's proposed recommendations and I don't want to spend more than 15 minutes on these, okay? Because this will bleed into the other time that we have to discuss all the walkthrough of the report. So one, and I want to make sure that everybody has it.